Make sure they're going game speed.
All right, here live at Tyne Davis Gymnasium for this, finally, a return to action for the Faulkner men's basketball team. The Eagles come in today at 9-2, hosting the Bears of Truett-McConnell. We are joined now by Drew Wilson, the assistant men's basketball coach. Drew, a long layoff after a couple of disappointing performances on the road. Left kind of a bad taste in your mouth over the holiday. How have you guys processed it?
Yeah, no question. It was one of the shorter breaks we've had over a long time. I told Coach it felt like forever because we got beat twice, which we don't usually do right before the break. So yeah. So it felt like a long time. But, it was really good. We got back to practice on the 26th. Gave the guys off through Christmas, got back to practice on the 26th, practiced five times between 26th and today. So, we've had really good time to process it, get through it, work on us, get back to hopefully playing like we're capable of playing today.
The two big things that jumped out at me on the road trip, one in particular, turnovers, a major problem in both of those games. When that's a problem for a basketball team, how do you coach through it? Like, what do you talk to them about?
Well, you gotta try to eliminate the unforced ones. We went back and charted, and we had 56 turnovers on the weekend. 37 of them were unforced, meaning we just threw the ball out of bounds, or we traveled, or we just little goofy stuff that we can eliminate. And going into that weekend, we were averaging like 10 a game. We turned it over like 92 times in 9 games, and then we go and turn it over 57 in 2. So. Just not characteristic of our team, and so we got to try to eliminate, like I said, the unforced ones, and you coach through that, and because guys are going to turn the ball over some, and you don't want them looking over their shoulder like, oh, am I coming out if I turn the ball over? Just talk about eliminating the unforced ones a lot.
Despite the turnover issues, you're still right there close to your scoring average on the year, which means the problem on the road in large part was defense, mm-hmm. Especially at Loyola. Didn't seem to stop anybody on almost any possession. What were the lapses about defensively?
Well, some of it is, you turn the ball over and they're going to lay the ball up on the other end. There's no defense for that. So those kind of play together. I thought at Loyola we kind of got away from who we were defensively a little bit and, not really in the gaps and doing those kind of things like we're taught. At Cary we were better defensively. We turned it over 30 times again. Some of those against the press, there's no defense for those. You can't really guard guys when you turn the ball over that way.
All right, this is a Truett-McConnell team that comes in. Not a bad rebounding team, averaging 38 boards a contest, averaging 75 points, almost 76 a game. What does this team do well?
Very good, very athletic, play about 8 guys. They're athletic. They got a couple guys with a quick trigger who can really shoot the ball, and they're 2 inside guys. Like you said, they're just high energy, play hard, score the ball around the rim very, very well. So we'll have our hands full today. Game that it's our last non-league game of the year. Got a chance to go perfect in non-conference play, which is something that hadn't been done here at Faulkner in a long time. So that's exciting. But we got to play well. We got to do what we do well and in order to beat these guys.
Yep. Last tune up before you get back into that league play next week. A couple of big games: Dalton State, Martin Methodist.
Yeah.
And then you're really in the thick of things: Stillman and Mobile the following week. What are you wanting to see this team really emerge from today with as they get ready for that full slate of league play?
Yeah. You just want to get back to playing like we were playing the first 9 games. You want to not turn the ball over, no unforced turnovers. You want to play. Get the ball up and down the floor like we're accustomed to doing and really rise to the challenge and rebound the ball well like we're capable of doing.
Fantastic. That's Drew Wilson, assistant men's basketball coach for the Faulkner Eagles. We pause for a moment on this Faulkner Sports Network presentation of Faulkner Eagle basketball.
Maybe you need to update your life insurance coverage. Perhaps you're thinking about retirement. It could be an accident or a cancer policy that you're seeking. Whatever your insurance needs, make sure that you're covered at a rate that makes sense for you and your family. That's where Ronnie Polk and Benefit Planners can help. Call Ronnie or Brian at 334-495-7476. Call Benefit Planners and make sure that your family is covered. Odds are you've never seen service like what you'll see when you go into Don Duncan's All-American Auto and Tire. They rotate your tires and vacuum out your vehicle just because you came in for an oil change. And if you call Nathan at the downtown Montgomery location at 334-263-3872, he'll pick up your car and bring it back to you when the job is done. They've got three locations to serve you, and they'll give you 10% off with your Faulkner ID. Don Duncan's All-American Auto and Tire, downtown Montgomery, the corner of Bell and Vaughn and Millbrook.
Located on Boyd Cooper Parkway in East Chase, Candlewood Suites is one of the premier lodging destinations in Montgomery. All rooms are big enough for the whole family, and they offer a super rate for Faulkner folks. Next time you're in town to see the Eagles play in person, book your stay at Candlewood Suites of East Chase Park. Call 334-277-0677 and have a super night's sleep. Wherever you are in your financial needs, Guardian Credit Union can probably help. From auto to home to signature loans, Guardian has the best rates you'll find anywhere. They even do credit cards with no annual fees. Join today and get your Eagle credit or debit card. With locations all over Montgomery, Guardian Credit Union is here to serve.
The Faulkner family is so proud to again partner with Wells Printing. They can meet virtually every print need, from commercial and wide format printing to promotional products and apparel. They even do full service mailing and distribution. For all of your promotional and print needs, make the right call and stand out with Wells. Call Amanda at 334-270-9481 or 334-324-0864.
I don't know if there's anything I like better than good barbecue. Full Moon has the best barbecue and best smoked wings in town, and those onion rings are out of this world. Go by after the game and use your ticket for a buy one, get one free barbecue sandwich. Say hi to Chris in person at 7660 East Chase Parkway, or give him a call at 334-676-5999.
Whether you're making the trip to see the Eagles play in person, coming into town to visit your favorite Faulkner student, or having the family in from out of town, Drury Inn and Suites is Faulkner's number one place to stay in Montgomery. Drury offers a full free breakfast and dinner with your stay and caters to your needs with a friendly and knowledgeable staff. They're pet friendly and offer a great Faulkner rate. They've even got indoor and outdoor pool options. Call them at 334-273-1101 to book your stay today.
All right, back here live at Tyne Davis Gymnasium. We are some 5.5 minutes away from tip here on a Saturday afternoon game between the Faulkner men's basketball team, the Eagles of Faulkner, coming in at 9-2, and Truett-McConnell in at 6-6. I am Jeremy Smith alongside David Turner. First, the lineups, the starting lineup for the visiting Truett-McConnell Bears. Senior forward number 2, a 6'6 senior forward from Rome, Georgia. We're going to get it together here in a moment. All right, reboot.
Reboot.
Word vomits reboot. Out. 6'6 senior forward from Rome, Georgia, Jacob Brook. A 5'11 senior guard from North Augusta, South Carolina, Christian Davis. A 6'2 wing, a junior from Lawrenceville, Georgia, Kai Lambert. 6'6 sophomore forward from Fairburn, Georgia, Calvin White. and a 6'3 sophomore guard from Denver, North Carolina, Miles Monroe. The starting five for the Eagles today, largely traditional with one exception. David, what's the lineup for Faulkner?
Like you said, it's largely traditional. They're going to go with number 10, Sean Edwards, the senior guard. The switch is going to be number 15. Nate Bradley is going to be moved into the starting lineup today, the junior guard. We'll also have number 20, Milan Skundrich. He'll be another staple in the starting lineup here this afternoon. And number 23, C.J. Jones, the junior guard. And 33, Adnan Halilovich will be the man in the middle, as it were, for the Eagles this afternoon.
And David, Drew Wilson talked a lot about it leading into this game, setting up our broadcast right off the top. The thing that plagued them on the road at Loyola and at William Carey more than anything, turnovers. And that created a lot of that defensive issue as well. 57 turnovers over two games, very un-Faulkner-like. So what do you look for out of the Eagles today?
Well, it's going to be how they respond to that. You know, coming off two bad games like that where you're turning the ball over, how do you respond? You've had a lot of time to think about it. And how do you change those things? How do you correct some of those things and respond accordingly? And hopefully this afternoon we'll see them take care of the basketball. Like Drew said, begin to get up and down the floor again like they want to do and push the pace and defensively. He said, you know, when you turn the ball over, it's hard to defend those plays when you're giving up layups on the other end in fast break situations. So it's hard to defend those things. So if you can control those turnovers, you can try to get yourself back defensively where you want to be able to control what Faulkner likes to do. We've talked about it, keeping those teams shooting under 40% from the field on the four games. So let's see if they look have that rhythm about them today and they have that look on the defensive end.
This is a Bear squad that comes in shooting 35.7% from three on the season. They're allowing 37.3% from beyond the arc defensively. Their overall field goal percentage as a team is 42%, but David, not real good defensively, the numbers would say. They're allowing 48.2% to opponents shooting from the floor. They are a pretty good rebounding team, averaging 38.4 a night, giving up 38.6 a night. So they're gonna get just about half of the 50-50 balls, which is what you're looking for. 14.4 points per game for Miles Monroe. He is your leading scorer. Christian Davis averages 14 a game. 12.6 points per game for Calvin White. Their fourth leading scorer, not here today, that's Felipe Goncalves. He averages 10.9 a game. Their fifth leading scorer, Jacob Book, averages 10 a game. So that is a little bit of what you should see out of this Bear squad today. David, last we spoke, it was Renee Scott atop the scoring heap for Faulkner. A little bit of a change now. C.J. Jones, 16 points a game. After a big road trip, he is now the leading scorer. One of four Eagles averaging double figures. Who are the other three?
The other three are going to be Renee Scott, obviously. He's going to be the second leading scorer for the Eagles. He's averaging right under that 16 points per game. He's at 15.8. Then we've got Milan Skundrich, who is averaging right at 15, and he's got a couple big games for the Eagles early on this season. And the last man in double figures for this squad is Sean Edwards, number 10. He is averaging 10.8 points per game. And the leading rebounder for the Eagles is Skundrich. He's averaging right about 7.5 rebounds a game for the Eagles on the season.
All right, about 25 seconds until we get the festivities underway here with the playing of the national anthem and the starting lineups. We pause one more time before tip-off. This is the Faulkner Sports Network presentation, Faulkner Eagle Basketball.
Everyone knows Jason's Deli has the best salad bar in Montgomery. Everyone also knows Jason's Deli has the best sandwiches in town. And, of course, everyone knows Jason's Deli has the best ice cream anywhere. But did you know that Jason's Deli's manager is also named Jason? Give him a call at 334-409-9898. Or, better yet, just go by and see him at 1520 Eastern Boulevard in Montgomery.
Pizza for $5? Pizza for $5. Hot and ready pizza for $5. That's Little Caesars guarantee. Hot and ready pizzas every single day for $5. They're delivered to campus right here at Faulkner University. Order one or get enough for everybody. Call 334-272-4595 or stop by their location at 5853 Atlanta Highway in Eastdale Square. Nobody does service like Don Duncan's All-American Auto and Tire. That's not just hyperbole. With every oil change, they'll rotate your tires and vacuum out your car. That, Faulkner fans, is service. Show your Faulkner ID and get 10% off your purchase. Don Duncan's All-American Auto and Tire. Downtown Montgomery, at the corner of Bell and Vaughn, and in Millbrook.
For the best in starters, salads, steaks, ribs, country dinners, and more, saddle up after the game and head on over to Texas Roadhouse, located at 7525 East Chase Parkway in Montgomery. You can even take your Faulkner game ticket and Faulkner alumnus Trey, too, will gladly give you 10% off your bill. Call him for your catering needs at 334-396-7774 or go by and throw back a few peanuts while you wait on your meal. Texas Roadhouse, located in East Chase across from Target.
Wells Printing is so much more than just a print shop. Not only did they print up our Faulkner football game tickets, but they also carry Faulkner polos and Comfort Colors t-shirts, as well as those awesome baseball caps and stadium seats. For any and all printing and promotional item needs, call Amanda at 334-270-9481 or 334-324-0864.
Okay, so it's a given that they've got the catchiest jingle of all time. But Cook's has used reliable, affordable, expert service to become number one in the pest control business. Nobody wants the uninvited guests at their game day parties. Call Cook's Pest Control to handle the problem outside before it moves its way inside. Call Mike at 334-273-8873 and get a free quote today.
From hand-breaded chicken fingers and fried chicken to delicious sides and scratch-made biscuits, Jack's has all the ingredients to make your next tailgate legendary. Football is just better with Jack's, so order ahead at eatatjacks.com and score big this season.
All right, starting lineups for Truett-McConnell has been announced. As expected, Jacob Book, Christian Davis, Kai Lambert, Calvin White, and Miles Monroe. Five starters for Faulkner, Sean Edwards, Nate Bradley, Milan Skundrich, C.J. Jones, and Adnan Halilovic. Ready to go for tip here as we greet Monte Sanford, one of the graduate assistants, or the graduate assistant on this team. David, coming off of the type of road trip that Faulkner had going into Christmas break, you remember as a former athlete, when you have to sit in a loss that, and a bad performance more than anything else for that long, how bitter is that wait and how eager are you to get back on the floor?
It's bad. It's real bitter. You can't wait to get back out on the court in a game situation. A lot of times over a Christmas break, your practices when you first come back, they're sloppy. But coming in with that kind of taste, you might be more focused and ready to go.
Tip up and controlled by Truett-McConnell. In the circle was Calvin White, the 6'6 forward, jumping against Milan Skundrich. Ball over right wing, Miles Monroe. That's the Bears' leading scorer. He attacks baseline, kicks it back left. Jacob Book, three, no good. Rebound ripped down by Adnan Halilovic. Sean Edwards will lead the break, quicken the pace. Right wing, Nate Bradley back over to Edwards. Resets up around the eagle head, 22 on the shot clock. Edwards hands it off to Jones. Now back to Bradley on the weave. Edwards again. Edwards tightly guarded, attacks right side, two men in his face. Splits two defenders, hits C.J. Jones. Goes down to Halilovic, back up Jones, right wing. He will send it down. Halilovic near the right block, four on the shot clock. Skundrich will fire the jumper off the assist from Halilovic, and Faulkner draws first blood.
It's good curl there by Skoundrich coming off the top, wide open at the free throw line for that easy jumper.
Jacob Book hands it off Christian Davis. Now it goes over Kyle Lambert, swings it back around Jacob Book. Left wing, the attack, Miles Monroe splits two defenders, loses the ball. Sean Edwards comes out with it, and Faulkner has numbers, 4-on-2 on the break. Left wing, C.J. Jones back up to Bradley, over to Halilovic looking for somebody. He'll feed down to Skoundrich. Up top, Edwards, he'll pull the wide open three, and it is no good. Back iron, Halilovic with the long board. Back up to Edwards around half court, sends it over to Bradley, and he'll be called for a walk. Truett-McConnell escaped what looked like sure disaster there. 4-on-2, Faulkner had the numbers, but they did a nice job recovering.
They did. Good job closing out there on Jones in the corner, making Faulkner have to pull the ball back up and reset and try to get something going offensively.
Top of the key is Jacob Book. He works against Trace Hill, the first Faulkner sub of the day. He came in place of Milan Skoundrich. There's a long pass. The drive in contact, offensive foul called on number 10, Calvin White.
Faulkner's come out here in their customary man-to-man defense. Already gotten themselves a turnover, or a couple turnovers, trying to push the pace back the other way. As McConnell sets up here in a full court pressure here to try to slow Edwards down as he brings the ball up the court for the Eagles.
Defended by Christian Davis. Works around right side, now feeds Nate Bradley. Bradley inside high post, C.J. Jones jumper, no good. Rebound tipped alive by Trace Hill, but controlled by Kai Lambert of Truett-McConnell. Across the timeline comes Christian Davis, loses it momentarily, gets it back, kicks it out, Miles Monroe. He'll circle around the top of the key, ball finds its way to the left corner now. That's a shot off the hand of Christian Davis, no good. Rebound Sean Edwards in the open court. Pull-up jumper, free throw line, good. So the transfer from Freed Hardeman University drills that one. It's a 4-0 Faulkner lead.
It's a good push by Edwards there, stopping on the dime, pulling up for the open shot.
Davis works around top of the key, sends it over Kyle Lambert. Lambert around the volleyball lines looking for help. He's going to get it over left wing Christian Davis. Davis down toward the left block. Halilovic defends. There's a nice wraparound pass to an attacking Kyle Lambert and an easy bucket.
Great cut there by the McConnell wing, and Faulkner just asleep at the other side of that defensively and gave up an easy layup on that one.
Trace Hill, left wing C.J. Jones, down low Halilovic. He gets a man on his hip, takes him up. 5-6-2 now is the Faulkner lead after that lay-in. Right wing sends it top of the key. Book thought about it and thought better of it. Ball's in the left corner, a lot of traffic over there. Swings it back out to Kyle Lambert. Lambert to Christian Davis. He'll attack right side. Halilovic picks him up. Pass looks deflected, but Truett-McConnell controls it. Jacob Book, three, top of the key, good. 6-5, Faulkner leads. 16.5 to go in the opening half.
We're seeing good ball movement here by Truett-McConnell out of the opening gate here in this ball game, getting some several open shots.
Edwards attacks, kicks to Halilovic, pulls the three, good. When your five can drop that shot, it can be a pretty good day offensively.
Makes a huge difference in the ability that you have to be able to cut and move some offensive pieces around.
9-5 is the Faulkner advantage. Truett-McConnell with the basketball. Miles Monroe works around, feeds Christian Davis. A lot of contact, no call. Davis sends it back down in the area of the left block. There's contact again, and a second offensive foul called against Truett-McConnell. This one also on Calvin White. That's two on him.
Way to sell that foul there by Halilovic. He just kind of took a little bump there and went on down with it.
You mean European players know how to sell fouls?
Yeah, that's been the rumor anyway.
It's part of the game. Definitely part of the game, but Halilovic, though, did a good job, as you said, of selling that.
When it works in your favor, you'll take it.
That's right. Garrett Sanderson across the timeline gets it to Renee Scott. Scott, Hill, left wing Jones. Jones will split two defenders, pull up, jumper around the free throw line, no good. Jacob Book will get the easy long rebound across the timeline. Book sends it to Lambert, left wing Monroe, three, no good. Garrett Sanderson the rebound. Sanderson feeds Scott, pull up jumper, no. Rebound Halilovic, gets it out to Trace Hill. Hill out to Scott, it's tipped alive by Truett-McConnell and out of bounds, it'll stay with Faulkner. Christian Davis is a little bit of everywhere right now. He got his hand on that one.
He really is, showing a lot of effort and hustle on both ends of the floor for this Truett-McConnell team.
Trace Hill will inbound from in front of the scorer's table, gets it to Renee Scott. Scott across the timeline finds Garrett Sanderson right wing. Sanderson to Halilovic. Halilovic tried the handoff. It was knocked free. Halilovic gathers, gets it to Scott. Hill, Jones. Jones left wing, nowhere to go with it. Shot clock at 8. Renee Scott with it now. Shot clock at 5. They're going to have to do something with it. 3, 2, all the way in, gets it up. It never hits the iron. Shot clock violation. It's a turnover by Faulkner. Oh, they call the foul. A foul.
On the shot.
On the shot. So Renee Scott gets bailed out there. The call on Jacob Book, the 6'6 senior forward from Rome, Georgia. Renee Scott's first free throw is good. 10-5 is the Faulkner lead.
Got Luka Dimitrovic in for Adnan Halilovic, who had about 5 really good minutes here to start the game for Faulkner.
Shot up, no good on the second free throw, and we get another foul call. This one will go against the Eagles. It's on Luka Dimitrovic. Fresh into the game and already in the scorer's book. 10-5 is the Faulkner lead with 14:55 to go in the opening half of play. New guy in the game for Truett-McConnell's number 15, Anaka Frankie. Book with the ball. He finds Lambert. Lambert down to Frankie. Turnaround jumper and a foul call against Luka Dimitrovic. That's a quick 2. Luka Dimitrovic picks up 2 fouls in 14 seconds. So to the free throw line goes Frankie. Frankie listed as a 6'7 freshman forward from Cameroon. Missed the first free throw. 5-point Faulkner lead here as Frankie attempts the second free throw. It is good. And we'll have another substitution. Checking into the game is Darius Thrower, 6'1 junior guard from Ackworth, Georgia. He'll take the place of Miles Monroe. Skundrich gets the ball in to Nate Bradley. Bradley calls Skundrich off, waves off the screen, brings it across the timeline. Bradley works around the right, gets the screen from Skundrich, now sends it back to Dimitrovic. Entry pass is errant, rolls out of bounds. It's a Faulkner turnover. Dimitrovic comes out. Jacob Spence comes in.
In 1 minute. Two fouls and a freaking turnover.
14:27 to go in the opening half. 10-6 is the lead for Faulkner. Across the timeline is Christian Davis. Davis hands the ball off. Darius Thrower, he'll get it out to Kai Lambert. Lambert back to Thrower. Thrower defended tightly by Skundrich. Entry pass to Frankie. Frankie's jumper no good. Milan Skundrich with the rebound and another foul on the floor.
Foul's going to be on number 5 from Truett-McConnell, Kai Lambert.
That's his first. Skundrich gets the ball into Spence and gets it right back, and the point forward for Faulkner will bring it up the floor. He'll now hand it off to Nate Bradley. Bradley to Garrett Sanderson. Sanderson to Scott. Scott, 15 on the shot clock, attacks right side, pull-up jumper blocked by Frankie. McConnell coming the other way with it. Kyle Lambert with the basketball left wing. Finds Book up top. Book into Frankie. Frankie looking for the body, doesn't find it. Now he will send it back up top to Christian Davis with 15 on the shot clock. Davis right wing. That 3 off the hand of number 11 Thrower is no good. Rebound by Faulkner coming the other way. Bradley to Scott. Down low. Skundrich spins baseline and a travel. Another turnover for Faulkner.
Another turnover, another unforced turnover.
Yeah, it's exactly what Drew Wilson talked about in the pregame. Faulkner's got to get away from the unforced turnovers. You're going to have teams that will turn you over sometimes, but you can't give them gifts.
Right.
13-18 to play in the opening half. 10-6 is the lead for Faulkner. Down in the left wing is Kai Lambert. He will send it up to Xavier Latore. Sends it over to Jacob Book. Now back to Kai Lambert. Lambert to Frankie and gets it right back. A lot of ball movement for Truett-McConnell here. Christian Davis attacks off the screen from Frankie, and the 3 is good. Frankie created the opportunity with the screen, and Davis didn't waste it.
A lot of ball movement for Truett-McConnell. A lot of screens being set for each other on that end of the floor for them.
Garrett Sanderson attacks around on the top of the key. Sends it right wing, Renee Scott. Scott jab step attacks, layup no good. Rebound, Spence put back good.
Good hustle and follow there by Spence to be the right place at the right time for that putback.
Christian Davis attacks left side, sends it Jacob Book. He pulls the three, no good. Rebound Kai Lambert. Milan Skundrich with the block and the board, and he's fouled. So the block and the rebound for Skundrich, and he gets fouled in the process.
Foul is going to be on number 24, Xavier LaTorre. That is his first time on the afternoon.
Adnan Halilovic and Sean Edwards come back in, the five for Faulkner. Sanderson, Bradley, Skundrich, Edwards, Halilovic. Edwards with the basketball. He'll be picked up really about three-quarter court by Christian Davis. Davis will now go back over to Edwards after the momentary switch. The shot misses. Rebound Jacob Book. Davis across the timeline. Long pass. The attack by LaTorre. It's blocked by Halilovic. Johnny on the spot is Adnan Halilovic coming up with that block. That forces the timeout call. 12-9. Faulkner leads. 12 minutes to go. This is in the opening half, our media timeout. This is the Faulkner Sports Network presentation of Faulkner Eagle Basketball.
Assure your team's victory this season. Buy a dozen Jack's biscuits starting at just $15. Mix and match until you get the combination just right. After all, football is better with Jack's. Order ahead at eatatjacks.com. Score big this football season.
Maybe you need a loan to help you slide behind the wheel of that new Ryan. Perhaps it's a home loan or a HELOC you're seeking. Guardian Credit Union can help. With competitive interest rates on every loan product, Guardian is here to serve you with an unparalleled level of customer service, state-of-the-art online banking, and locations all over Montgomery.
12-9 is the Faulkner lead. 12 minutes to go in the opening half of play. Couple of blocks on the last couple of McConnell trips, a Milan Skundrich block and an Adnan Halilovic block have helped to preserve this Eagle lead. Good pace to this one so far. LaTorre throws the ball in. That's Darius Tisby. Christian Davis working against Bradley, attacks right side, back to Tisby, and he's called for the travel. So Darius Tisby, the travel, it's a Truett-McConnell turnover. 11:53 to go in the half. Faulkner gets the ball back. Sean Edwards with it across the timeline. He'll attack, split the defense, kick it out. Nate Bradley. Bradley back to Edwards, and another whistle. We're going to get.
I think we got a travel.
We're going to get a travel and another Faulkner turnover. So a fourth Faulkner turnover. There is an attack, and he'll pull it back out, kick it to Christian Davis. Long pass over to Tisby. Tisby up to LaTorre. LaTorre back to number 32, Antonio Bonilla. Bonilla attacks, pull-up jumper, good. Long pass, Garrett Sanderson. He'll go down baseline, feeds Halilovic back out to Skundrich, and another travel call. Five Faulkner turnovers. Trace Hill will check into the game now. Skundrich comes out. Faulkner having a hard time getting any in an offensive set because of their inability to take care of the basketball.
They really are at this point of the ball game. Most of their points coming in some form of transition, whether it's the primary break or the secondary break for this Eagle team.
Left wing is basketball to Tisby. Tisby down to Frankie. He loses it. Bradley will come away with it. He will pull it back up to Halilovic. Long pass, Sanderson. He corrals it. Sanderson attacks all the way in through two defenders. Won't go. Gets his own rebound. Out to Sean Edwards. Edwards over to Trace Hill. Back to Edwards. Edwards long pass into the corner. That's Sanderson. Feeds Halilovic, and he's fouled.
Good bounce pass into the post there by Sanderson as Halilovic was set up, ready to make his move in the post. And as soon as he does, he gets the foul, and he gets rewarded going to the free throw line.
Adnan Halilovic to the line. The foul was on Darius Tisby. Halilovic sets and shoots. The first one is good.
Faulkner now in the bonus for the remainder of the half with 10:29 remaining.
Halilovic's next shot forthcoming. That one is good as well. So Adnan Halilovic, 5 points early on for Faulkner here. Or seven, I'm sorry. I missed one of his shots. He's already got seven. Miles Monroe with the basketball sends it around to Bonilla. Bonilla sends it baseline, and they will look like it may have been clean. They're going to call basket interference, give the bucket to Truett-McConnell. Trace Hill inbounds it to Sean Edwards. Edwards across the timeline. He'll be greeted by Miles Monroe. He goes around two defenders, kicks it to Bradley, over to Hill, back to Halilovic, down to C.J. Jones. Jones will attack and now back out to Edwards, sends it to Bradley, pull-up jumper, no. Passes it down to Hill, another turnover. It's Kai Lambert that comes away with the steal.
A little too unselfish there, Bradley on that. Had the open jump shot and looked to force a pass down low and wasn't quite ready to receive the pass down there and turns the ball over, but they get a gift and come back the other way with it. It's falling.
Yeah. Fortunately, Kai Lambert drags that plant leg, and it's a turnover right back. Sean Edwards now left side over to C.J. Jones, down to Adnan Halilovic. Nearly loses it, feeds Jones. He misses the shot. That rebound controlled by number 55, Matthew McDonough. Left wing is Bonilla. He sends it over to Miles Monroe. Monroe works around the face of the basket, sends it to Bonilla. Long three, no good. Rebound Adnan Halilovic. Halilovic feeds Bradley. Long pass C.J. Jones. He'll pull up that three, no good. And over and out of bounds. So it doesn't count as a turnover, but it basically works the same way.
Works the same way.
14-13 with 9:11 to play in the opening half. Not an offensive showcase for either team to this point. Miles Monroe works around to the left, gets it to Bonilla. Bonilla to McDonough, back to Lambert, over to Bonilla again. Bonilla hands off to Monroe. He'll spin around, right hand, no good. Rebound, put back, no good. That was Bonilla on the rebound and the put back, and then Halilovic cleared the miss for Faulkner. Bradley attacks, layup, good. Nate Bradley with the floater. Faulkner leads 16-13.
Nice attack by Bradley there on that secondary break. Just gets it in there. Beautiful little floater goes up and in to push the Eagle lead back up to three.
Bonilla to Tisby. Left wing to Monroe. Monroe double team. Gets it back out to Tisby. Shot clock inside 10. Tisby long pass Lambert. His three no good. Rebound Trace Hill. Trace Hill feeds Sean Edwards. Edwards will quicken the pace across the timeline. And they'll back it out and slow things down. Over to Trace Hill, back to Edwards again. Inside 20 on the shot clock. Down to C.J. Jones. He loses it. It's knocked out of bounds by Truett-McConnell.
Faulkner gets another gift there as Jones misplays the ball, the entry pass, and gets knocked out of bounds by Truett-McConnell, and Faulkner inbound underneath their own basket.
Book and Davis will check back in. One change for Faulkner as Renee Scott comes in, Nate Bradley comes out. Renee Scott will inbound underneath his own basket. Sends it to C.J. Jones. Jones to Edwards. Edwards face up with Kai Lambert, shot clock at 7. Edwards to Jones, back over to Hill, shot clock at 3. Gets it to Scott, he's got to get it off. No good. Rebound by Lambert, and It rolls around. They're going to call the shot clock violation because it didn't get to the rim before the shot. So another turnover for Faulkner.
It hit the rim. It's just knocked out of bounds by Truett-McConnell.
They'll call the offensive rebound now. Sorry. The offensive rebound, they'll give it to Renee Scott as it went off of Truett-McConnell. Gets it into Edwards. Faulkner playing a little fast and loose with that shot clock in a couple of these possessions. Scott back to Edwards. He'll pull the deep three. Good. 19-13. David, with the defensive length of Truett-McConnell, these smaller guards for Faulkner are going to have to be able to pull it from deep.
Yeah, they are. They're going to have to get that defense, make them come out on him, have to respect that jump shot to be able to get the inside looks they're wanting.
The three missed from Miles Monroe. Halilovic tipped the rebound out of bounds. So the ball will stay with Truett-McConnell. Monroe will throw it in.
And we've talked about this before, but Sean Edwards still shooting over 45% on the season from three, so he's accurate from range.
And a five-second violation. Truett-McConnell could not get it in. I thought it curious that one of the smaller players on the floor was the guy triggering that in. That created a problem for him that time. Edwards across the timeline. Hands it off to C.J. Jones. Jones to Renee Scott. Shot clock inside 20. Scott all the way in. A lot of contact, no call.
A lot of contact. A lot of, let's just call it like it was. It was a lot of foul right there that didn't get called. As Renee Scott took the ball inside.
Renee Scott took a jab on that play, but no call. 19-13, 6:55 to go in the opening half. Scott will trigger it in. He finds Adnan Halilovic up top. Halilovic pass down to Scott. Back up top, C.J. Jones. He almost loses it. Now over to Scott, right wing, pulls it. Three, no good. Rebound tipped alive, but a foul on the floor. Trace Hill draws the foul. It's Bonilla, Antonio Bonilla, that commits the foul. His first of the game. Trace Hill steps to the line. His first is no good. Rebound controlled by Kai Lambert. Lambert, right wing Bonilla. He attacks. It's knocked free by Halilovic, but Faulkner can't control it. I guess you'd call that a block for Halilovic there. He was attacking.
You would.
Didn't quite gather for the layup, but there's a timeout taken by Truett-McConnell. We'll take it with him. This is the Faulkner Sports Network presentation of Faulkner Eagle Basketball.
For the best in starters, salads, steaks, ribs, country dinners, and more, saddle up after the game and head on over to Texas Roadhouse, located at 7525 East Chase Parkway in Montgomery. You can even take your Faulkner game ticket and Faulkner alumnus Trey, too. We'll gladly give you 10% off your bill. Call him for your catering needs at 334-396-7774 or go by and throw back a few peanuts while you wait on your meal. Texas Roadhouse, located in East Chase across from Target.
19-13 is the Faulkner lead. Right wing Kai Lambert attacks. Now kicks it out, Christian Davis, long three, back iron, no good. Out of bounds, will go to Faulkner.
Tipped out there by Bonilla as he was fighting for that offensive rebound amongst three other Faulkner Eagles. Scott brings the ball up for the Eagles, cross half court, gets it to C.J. Jones, who kicks it to Garrett Sanderson, back to Jones. He puts up the three in and out.
McDonough controls the rebound, and coming the other way now is Truett-McConnell. Christian Davis gets the ball off to Kai Lambert, back to Book. Book face up with Trace Hill, feeds Davis, and he doesn't really have control of the ball before he fires a pass that goes out of bounds, and we'll take a media timeout. This is the Faulkner Sports Network presentation of Faulkner Eagle Basketball.
Maybe you need to update your life insurance coverage. Perhaps you're thinking about retirement.
It could be an accident or a cancer policy that you're seeking. Whatever your insurance needs, make sure that you're covered at a rate that makes sense for you and your family. That's where Ronnie Polk and Benefit Planners can help. Call Ronnie or Brian at 334-495-7476. Call Benefit Planners and make sure that your family is covered. Odds are you've never seen service like what you'll see when you go into Don Duncan's All-American Auto and Tire. They rotate your tires and vacuum out your vehicle just because you came in for an oil change. And if you call Nathan at the downtown Montgomery location at 334-263-3872, he'll pick up your car and bring it back to you when the job is done. They've got three locations to serve you, and they'll give you 10% off with your Faulkner ID. Don Duncan's All-American Auto and Tire, downtown Montgomery, the corner of Bell and Vaughn and Millbrook.
All right, back here live on the Faulkner Sports Network presentation of Faulkner Eagle Basketball. We are at Titan Davis Gymnasium. It's a 19-13 lead for Faulkner over Truett-McConnell. Inbound comes to Bonilla, and Antonio Bonilla strokes it off the inbound, drains the three, cuts it to 19-16 with 5:49 to play in the opening half. Skundrich's entry pass is stolen by Frankie. Frankie to Lambert. Over to Bonilla, back to Lambert, swings it left side, Christian Davis. Davis now finds Lambert right corner. He'll put it on the deck and attack. His layup is good, and it's a quick 5-0 run from Truett-McConnell that's cut it to one with 5:25 to go in the half.
Another Faulkner turnover leads to points for Truett-McConnell there.
And they turn it over here. Good. It's knocked free, and Skundrich is called for the foul, so it's another turnover and a foul here. That's two more turnovers out of that timeout, which puts Faulkner at eight right now. Across the timeline is Christian Davis. Truett-McConnell's down one. Bonilla with the basketball, sends it to Lambert. Kai Lambert hands it off to Jacob Book. Book thinks about it and now gets it to Frankie. Frankie will be called for the walk, so Truett-McConnell turns it back over. That's their eighth turnover. Ball into Renee Scott.
Well, Frankie's not extremely tall. He is very long. He has long arms and is able to move.
Yeah, he's listed at 6'7". As that shot misses, rebound controlled by Faulkner. He's listed at 6'7", but that wingspan's got to be every bit of 6'11".
At least. He's long, he's active defensively, and even offensively, he's been able to get several looks inside as C.J. Jones gets fouled on his three-point attempt.
So C.J. Jones to the free throw line. His first one is good. Believe it or not, David, that's the first point of the day for C.J. Jones.
Both teams at this point not shooting the ball particularly well at all.
Second free throw rattles around and in. Checking into the game now for the Bears is Darius Thrower. C.J. Jones' third free throw attempt. Is up and no good. So he hits two out of three. It's a 21-18 Faulkner lead. Truett-McConnell will inbound after the ball is knocked out of bounds by Adnan Halilovic. Christian Davis across the timeline gets it to number 11, Darius Thrower. Thrower to Book, Book to Bonilla. Bonilla back to Thrower. Thrower to Bonilla, and now out to Davis, shot clock at 14. Davis finds Thrower, attacks baseline, and now sends it out to Book, left corner, three, no good. Renee Scott with the rebound. Gets it out to Garrett Sanderson. Sanderson, long pass Halilovic, who touch passes it to Renee Scott. He'll reset everything up top, 20 on the shot clock, and an offensive foul called on C.J. Jones. Another unforced turnover by Faulkner.
Hit him with that moving screen there as he was looking to set Renee Scott for his move to the basket. Slid in to the defensive player a little bit. And as you said, that's another one of those turnovers that has really haunted this Faulkner team.
Book attacks left side, hands it off to Davis. His entry pass is lost by Truett-McConnell. And look, it seems every time Faulkner turns this ball over, Truett-McConnell responds by giving it right back to him.
Does him a favor and just gives it right back.
That pass to Nate Bradley. Bradley will bring it across the timeline, but will be defended by Christian Davis. Shot clock down at 20 now. Gets it back to Bradley, does Halilovic, and another whistle on the floor. We're going to get a foul call on Antonio Bonilla. Bonilla listed as a 6'1 guard from Tenafly, New Jersey. That is the second foul on Bonilla. So C.J. Jones steps to the line. First free throw is good, so he'll get to shoot the back end of this one-and-one opportunity. 22-18 is now the Faulkner lead. Dribbles right hand, spins left, dribbles again, and shoots. That one no good, back iron, rebound tipped high and controlled by Frankie. Frankie to Christian Davis across the timeline. Davis works around left side, back up to Book. Book, right wing, Bonilla. Bonilla, long pass to Thrower. Thrower to Davis. Davis back to Bonilla. And the three, good from Darius Thrower off the Bonilla assist. It's 22-21 now. Bradley hands off to C.J. Jones. Jones back to Scott. Scott attacks, now back out to Halilovic. Halilovic goes on the attack, left hand, good. He's got 9. Nice take by the Serbian.
Good take by Halilovic. He's had a fantastic half here this afternoon.
Christian Davis works around to the left, sends it right wing to Thrower, gets it down low to Frankie. Frankie pivots, right hand won't go. Rebound Book. Book feeds Davis, his 3 won't go. Rebound Nate Bradley, and he's fouled.
Should be a foul on Book there from Truett-McConnell.
Yeah, Book following his shot. No, they'll get Bonilla again.
Get Bonilla.
That's the 3rd on Bonilla. Book may have gotten away with one there, but that I would expect would send Bonilla to the bench. 24-21, 2:46 to go here in the opening half. Nate Bradley will shoot. His first is good. 25-21, now the Faulkner advantage. Sean Edwards will check in. Renee Scott came out. Second free throw from Bradley is short. Rebound controlled by Book. Gets it to Davis, now over to Thrower. Thrower across the timeline. Right wing to Davis. Davis, pull-up jumper, mid-range, good. 25-23, Truett-McConnell continuing to keep pace. Nate Bradley across the timeline with 2.5 to go in the half. Bradley, Halilovic, down low, Jones spins and takes it all the way in. 27-23, and a quick burst from C.J. Jones here. He's got 5. He had none just a couple of minutes ago. Davis attacks, gets it out to Book. Book down low and now back up top. So Book will work it around right wing. Christian Davis, 15 on the shot clock. Davis has the pass tipped alive out of bounds off the hands of Book.
A lot of movement by this McConnell offense, ball and player movement, but a lot of that is Faulkner's playing pretty good defense, forcing a lot of these passes by this Truett-McConnell team this afternoon.
Sean Edwards left wing sends it to Adnan Halilovic. He spins, and now the baseline pass won't go into the hands of Hill. It's another Faulkner turnover. 27-23 with 1:45 to play. Faulkner having a hard time putting together 3, 4, 5 possessions in a row.
They are, and a lot of it is they're turning the ball over and not getting those consistent looks and being able to set themselves up offensively.
Pull-up jumper, Frankie off the assist from Thrower. 27-25 is now the Faulkner lead with a 1:26 left in the half. Trace Hill, C.J. Jones. Jones works around right side, comes back left, attacks right, loses the basketball, stolen by Christian Davis. Another Truett-McConnell forced turnover there, and Jacob Book takes it all the way in. Faulkner now in double digits in turnovers.
That ties the ball game here with a minute left in the half.
Yeah, Faulkner's had the lead since the opening minute. C.J. Jones, Adnan Halilovic, hands it off back to Edwards. Edwards finds Halilovic, kicks it out to Bradley. Now back to Hill. He pulls the three, no good. Rebound Book. About an 18-second differential between shot clock and game clock, and Truett-McConnell with a chance to take the lead going into the locker room. That three, no good. Tipped alive. Rebound controlled by Nate Bradley, and he just loses the basketball.
Looking up to get the ball down the court and just misdribbled the ball there as he was trying to get the ball up court to C.J. Jones.
5.2-second differential between shot and game here as it'll be inbounded by Xavier LaTorre to Christian Davis. Truett-McConnell a chance to take its first lead of the afternoon. Davis content to dribble some clock here. Shot clock down to 16. Now they will go into the offensive set as Book calls it. LaTorre around the screen from Book, back up to Book. Shot clock at 4, 3, 2. Davis, right-hand runner, won't go. Gets it over to Halilovic, feeds Edwards. He'll pull the three at the buzzer. No!
It did go!
It went! Sean Edwards rolled it off the top of the iron and in after the buzzer sounded. And Faulkner takes a 30-27 lead at the half. But, boy, it shouldn't have been that close.
No, it shouldn't. These turnovers have really got Faulkner mugged down in here again in the mud and not been able to allow them to get going here offensively. Quite frankly, they're lucky to have the three-point lead at this point the way they've turned the ball over.
Absolutely. Truett-McConnell held on that last possession, attacked at the end of the shot clock. Davis's runner wouldn't go. Halilovic cleared the rebound and fed Sean Edwards. He pulled up about three-quarters court, rolled it off the front of the iron, and then in after the buzzer, and Faulkner leads 30-27 at halftime over Truett-McConnell. We pause. This is the Faulkner Sports Network presentation of Faulkner Eagle Basketball.
Maybe you need to update your life insurance coverage. Perhaps you're thinking about retirement. It could be an accident or a cancer policy that you're seeking. Whatever your insurance needs, make sure that you're covered at a rate that makes sense for you and your family. That's where Ronnie Polk and Benefit Planners can help. Call Ronnie or Brian at 334-495-7476. Call Benefit Planners and make sure that your family is covered.
Odds are you've never seen service like what you'll see when you go into Don Duncan's All-American Auto and Tire. They rotate your tires and vacuum out your vehicle just because you came in for an oil change. And if you call Nathan at the downtown Montgomery location at 334-263-3872, he'll pick up your car and bring it back to you when the job is done. They've got three locations to serve you, and they'll give you 10% off with your Faulkner ID. Don Duncan's All-American Auto and Tire, downtown Montgomery, the corner of Bell and Vaughn and Millbrook.
Located on Boyd Cooper Parkway in East Chase, Candlewood Suites is one of the premier lodging destinations in Montgomery. All rooms are big enough for the whole family, and they offer a super rate for Faulkner folks. Next time you're in town to see the Eagles play in person, book your stay at Candlewood Suites of East Chase Park. Call 334-277-0677 and have a super night's sleep.
Wherever you are in your financial needs, Guardian Credit Union can probably help. From auto to home to signature loans, Guardian has the best rates you'll find anywhere. They even do credit cards with no annual fees. Join today and get your Eagle credit or debit card. With locations all over Montgomery, Guardian Credit Union is here to serve.
The Faulkner family is so proud to again partner with Wells Printing. They can meet virtually every print need, from commercial and wide format printing to promotional products and apparel. They even do full service mailing and distribution. For all of your promotional and print needs, make the right call and stand out with Wells. Call Amanda at 334-270-9481 or 334-324-0864.
I don't know if there's anything I like better than good barbecue. Full Moon has the best barbecue and best smoked wings in town, and those onion rings are out of this world. Go by after the game and use your ticket for a buy one, get one free barbecue sandwich. Say hi to Chris in person at 7660 East Chase Parkway, or give him a call at 334-676-5999.
Whether you're making the trip to see the Eagles play in person, coming into town to visit your favorite Faulkner student, or having the family in from out of town, Drury Inn and Suites is Faulkner's number one place to stay in Montgomery. Drury offers a full free breakfast and dinner with your stay and caters to your needs with a friendly and knowledgeable staff. They're pet friendly and offer a great Faulkner rate. They've even got indoor and outdoor pool options. Call them at 334-273-1101 to book your stay today.
Everyone knows Jason's Deli has the best salad bar in Montgomery. Everyone also knows Jason's Deli has the best sandwiches in town. And, of course, everyone knows Jason's Deli has the best ice cream anywhere. But did you know that Jason's Deli's manager is also named Jason? Give him a call at 334-409-9898, or better yet, just go by and see him at 1520 Eastern Boulevard in Montgomery.
Pizza for $5? Pizza for $5. Hot and ready pizza for $5. That's Little Caesars guarantee. Hot and ready pizzas every single day for $5. They deliver to campus right here at Faulkner University. Order one or get enough for everybody. Call 334-272-4595 or stop by their location at 5853 Atlanta Highway in Eastdale Square.
Nobody does service like Don Duncan's All-American Auto and Tire. That's not just hyperbole. With every oil change, they'll rotate your tires and vacuum out your car. That, Faulkner fans, is service. Show your Faulkner ID and get 10% off your purchase. Don Duncan's All-American Auto and Tire. Downtown Montgomery, at the corner of Bell and Vaughn, and in Millbrook.
For the best in starters, salad, steaks, ribs, country dinners, and more, saddle up after the game and head on over to the Texas Roadhouse, located at 7525 East Chase Parkway in Montgomery. You can even take your Faulkner game ticket and Faulkner alumnus tray too. We'll gladly give you 10% off your bill. Call him for your catering needs at 334-396-7774 or go by and throw back a few peanuts while you wait on your meal. Texas Roadhouse, located in East Chase across from Target.
Wells Printing is so much more than just a print shop. Not only did they print up our Faulkner football game tickets, but they also carry Faulkner polos and Comfort Colors t-shirts, as well as those awesome baseball caps and stadium seats. For any and all printing and promotional item needs, call Amanda at 334-270-9481 or 334-324-0864.
Okay, so it's a given that they've got the catchiest jingle of all time. But Cook's has used reliable, affordable, expert service to become number one in the pest control business. Nobody wants the uninvited guests at their game day parties. Call Cook's Pest Control to handle the problem outside before it moves its way inside. Call Mike at 334-273-8873 and get a free quote today. Maybe you need a loan to help you slide behind the wheel of that new Ryan. Perhaps it's a home loan or a HELOC you're seeking. Guardian Credit Union can help. With competitive interest rates on every loan product, Guardian is here to serve you with an unparalleled level of customer service, state-of-the-art online banking, and locations all over Montgomery.
From hand-breaded chicken fingers and fried chicken to delicious sides and scratch-made biscuits, Jack's has all the ingredients to make your next tailgate legendary. Football is just better with Jack's. So order ahead at eatatjacks.com and score big this season.
Located on Boyd Cooper Parkway in East Chase, Candlewood Suites is one of the premier lodging destinations in Montgomery. All rooms are big enough for the whole family and they offer a super rate for Faulkner folks. Next time you're in town to see the Eagles play in person, book your stay at Candlewood Suites of East Chase Park. Call 334-277-0677 and have a super night's sleep.
Back here live at Tyne-Davis Gymnasium as we're ready for the second half. Faulkner leading Truett-McConnell 30-27, thanks in large part to a last-second caromed in buzzer-beater three from Sean Edwards. Faulkner has not yet trailed in this game, but boy, they flirted with disaster a few times. 12 turnovers for the Eagles, but Truett-McConnell with 10 of their own has largely allowed Faulkner to keep the lead throughout most of this one.
It has, and those turnovers, like talked about before the game started, a lot of them have been that unforced variety, just travels or something to that nature that is that's really kind of plagued this team the last few weeks, and we're seeing it here today, and we've kind of got from Truett-McConnell a balanced scoring attack. No one really standing out. We've got Benia and Kai Lambert with five each.
Christian Davis also with five.
Yes, I missed him. But
yeah, Kai Lambert with four. There you go.
There you go.
Christian Davis five. All right.
Leading the way for Truett-McConnell, and then we've got for Faulkner. Adnan Halilovic had a fantastic half with 9.6 rebounds. Probably his best half of the year.
Two assists and two blocked shots as well.
And Sean Edwards with 8 points, assisted with that buzzer beater there at the end of the half.
So the big number that jumps out at me right now is Sean Edwards has the ball. Bench points, David. Truett-McConnell with 15, only three for the Eagles. And that's got to change.
The bench has been a big part of this Faulkner attack most of the year, and you think having Renee Scott on your bench today, you'd get some scoring out of that.
Edwards feeds Jones, who misses the three. Skundrich fights for the rebound, hits an attacking Jones. He's blocked from behind by number 10, Calvin White. White went to the bench early with foul trouble. Didn't play much of the first half, but he makes an impact on the first possession of the second half. 19-19 to go in the game. Calvin White with the basketball sends it over to Thrower. Right wing Lambert, now Book. His shot won't go. Rebound C.J. Jones. Coming the other way is Faulkner, Sean Edwards, Nate Bradley. Bradley back to Edwards. Thought about it, thought better of it, backs it out, looks for help, finds Skundrich. He will send it right wing, wide open three. Nate Bradley, no good. Rebound Adnan Halilovic. That's his seventh. Halilovic, left wing, throws it away. C.J. Jones got it. Planted a little bit too long and started a little bit too late, and that ball goes into the stands. 30-27 is the Faulkner lead. Right wing Christian Davis brings it around the top of the key, face up with Milan Skundrich. Now he sends the ball to Calvin White. White finds Lambert, left wing, three. Good by Thrower, and we're tied again. 18-26 to go in the ballgame. Sean Edwards, Nate Bradley, Milan Skundrich, C.J. Jones, Adnan Halilovic, you're five. And that's Skundrich to Halilovic, and he gets blocked by Thrower.
Great help side defense there by Thrower to block the shot of Halilovic because he was wide open underneath the basket there. But Halilovic perseveres and gets rewarded with a trip to the free throw line as he collected himself and went back up and got fouled.
That call on Kai Lambert, that's his third foul. Adnan Halilovic's first free throw is good, and he's in double figures with 10. I think that's his first double-digit scoring game of the season, if I'm not mistaken.
I believe you're right.
Halilovic's second free throw is good. He's got 11. Inbound comes to Christian Davis. He'll come across the timeline. Right wing to White, over to Thrower, back up Jacob Book. Book, right wing, finds Kai Lambert. Now back to Lambert again. Lambert to Book, top of the key, swings it left wing Christian Davis. He'll attack and back it out. Now goes right side around Skundrich, backs it out again. Long pass thrown away. That is a Truett-McConnell turnover. They've had plenty of those of their own. And a timeout taken by Truett-McConnell. We'll take it with them. This is the Faulkner Sports Network presentation of Faulkner Eagle Basketball.
Wherever you are in your financial needs, Guardian Credit Union can probably help. From auto to home to signature loans, Guardian has the best rates you'll find anywhere. They even do credit cards with no annual fees. Join today and get your Eagle credit or debit card. With locations all over Montgomery, Guardian Credit Union is here to serve.
The Faulkner family is so proud to again partner with Wells Printing. They can meet virtually every print need, from commercial and wide format printing to promotional products and apparel. They even do full service mailing and distribution. For all of your promotional and print needs, make the right call and stand out with Wells. Call Amanda at 334-270-9481 or 334-324-0864.
Shot up, no good. Rebounded by Calvin White. I'll correct myself from earlier. This is the fourth game this year Adnan Halilovic has scored in double figures.
All right, we're both wrong.
Yeah.
All right.
Left wing, Jacob Book, his three goes, and Truett-McConnell's got its first lead of the night. Afternoon, whatever.
Whatever we're in now.
Sean Edwards across the timeline. He feeds Adnan Halilovic. Halilovic finds Skoundrich. Skoundrich, Edwards, his three, no. Rebound, Adnan Halilovic feeds Skoundrich again. A lollipop pass up, Halilovic, turnaround jumper, good. 34-33, Faulkner back on top.
Nice feed from Skoundrich into Halilovic there, who turns and gets the basket up.
That right hand of Halilovic has got him 13 points tonight. Ball stolen by Halilovic, but he can't control it. Now it finds its way to Calvin White. His layup puts Truett-McConnell back on top. Edwards across the timeline. Hits Skoundrich. Skoundrich dumps it down. C.J. Jones, he'll find Halilovic. Gets a defender on his back. No call, but he puts it in. He's got 15.
Good hesitation by Halilovic. Gives a little pump fake, gets his man in the air, and then goes right back up with it for the easy bucket.
And Edwards slaps it away, and he's called for the foul. 36-35 is the Faulkner lead. Truett-McConnell with the basketball into Christian Davis. Davis attacks left side. Long pass stolen by Sean Edwards. And he spins through contact. They'll call him for the walk.
Good hustle to get back there by Christian Davis. Make Sean Edwards pick his dribble up to some degree and force him to make a move he wasn't ready to make.
Jacob Book throws it in to Christian Davis. Across the timeline, he goes to Kyle Lambert. Lambert around top of the key. Finds a cutting Davis, dribbles it back out to Book. Now throws it to Davis, tipped out of bounds by Milan Skoundrich. Renee Scott and Garrett Sanderson check in. Out comes Nate Bradley. And here comes Sean Edwards. And now Trace Hill will check in. Out comes Milan Skoundrich. ...36-35 is the lead. 15-36 to go in the ball game. White with the ball over to Christian Davis. Right side thrower. Now it's down into the left corner. Christian Davis back up to White again. He attacks, hesitates, finds thrower. His three is good. Didn't look pretty, but it went.
It went, gives Truett-McConnell the lead back, 38-36, with 15 minutes, 9 seconds left in the second half.
Halilovic's pass is deflected. Renee Scott chases it down. Scott attacks, layup, no, contact. And this time he will get the call. A couple of times tonight he's been hit and there's been no call. This call will go against Christian Davis.
Needless to say, Renee Scott spent a lot of the afternoon getting hit, one way or the other.
Yes, he has. Renee Scott's first free throw up and good. 38-37 is the Truett-McConnell lead. Nate Bradley back into the game. C.J. Jones comes out. Second free throw by Scott, no good. Rebounded by Calvin White. 38-37 is the Faulkner lead, or is the Truett-McConnell lead, rather. The attack, the pivot, steps back, sends it to Book. Now finds its way to LaTorre. Christian Davis, pull-up jumper, free throw line, no good. Nate Bradley with the rebound. It's stolen by Christian Davis.
He's going to get the timeout call for Truett-McConnell to retain possession. Smart play there by the senior guard.
Yeah, Christian Davis, a 5'11 senior guard from North Augusta, South Carolina, a transfer from Division II North Greenville University, has been very good for Truett-McConnell today. And a lot of that doesn't show up in the stat sheet, but he's just done a lot of really smart things, little things that you want your point guard, especially a senior point guard to do. And that, a great example of the hustle that he's had all afternoon.
Absolutely, and he's one of those leading scorers we talked about at the top of the game today, averaging about 14 points a game for this Truett-McConnell team. So he's doing it there as well, but also, as you just mentioned, it leading this team, doing those little things, being that point guard, getting the offense going, and you've seen a lot of that here this afternoon by Christian Davis.
38-37 is the Truett-McConnell lead with 14:36 to go in the game. They will emerge from their respective benches here, and we will resume play. Three full timeouts left for Truett-McConnell. Faulkner with a full slate of timeouts. Drew Wilson checking on that here during the break. Book with the basketball. He finds Thrower. Thrower to White, back over to Davis. Davis, his pass tipped alive by Trace Hill and out of bounds. It'll stay with Truett-McConnell with 15 on the shot clock.
Good hustle by Trace Hill coming back, trying to get the steal on that pass.
Davis around the top. He attacks into the corner to Thrower. Thrower throws it away. Sanderson comes up with it, and he's fouled as he tries to get the pass out to Hill. Pick your poison on who fouled him there. That time it will go on Jacob Book. 38-37, Faulkner trails 14-13 to play. They get it in to Nate Bradley. Bradley to Hill. Hill has it tipped away by Davis. Thrower, Davis. Davis lay in. 40-37. Turnovers continuing to be a problem for the Eagles.
And that was one of those that there's just no answer for defensively. Just gets it knocked away, and heady play there by Truett-McConnell all the way around.
Scott Sanderson, his three from the corner, no good. Rebound, Calvin White. White out to Book. Book, long pass into the corner. That's LaTorre, his three, no good. Rebound, Adnan Halilovic. He gets it out to Renee Scott. That's a double-double for Adnan Halilovic, the first of his career. Adnan Halilovic pulls it from three, good! It's the Adnan game, 18-10 right now for the Serbian center.
Might as well be. He's the guy that's gotten here today and has been ready to play and has had a really good afternoon for this Eagle basketball club.
Thrower to Book. Book, right wing Christian Davis. He'll bring it around, back it out, finds White. He pulls the three. No good. Rebound tipped alive. Adnan Halilovic again. Sanderson attacks. Contact. Offensive call against Garrett Sanderson. The referee throws up a circle and gets everybody at the scorer's table. Garrett Sanderson's first foul. 12:57 to go in the game. Book gets it into Christian Davis. He comes across the timeline. Book to Kyle Lambert. Lambert. Right wing Calvin White gets it to Christian Davis. Davis attacks, now back over to White. He has a hard time gathering it. They'll close off the space, and now it's swung up to Book. His three misses. Adnan Halilovic with another rebound. 18-12 right now. Edwards, Jones, head fake, pull up, mid-range, no. Rebound, White.
Smart play by Jones there to take the head fake, get your rhythm dribble in, take the open two, but just not there for him.
It's Davis gathers his own loose ball, but then throws it out of bounds. So Faulkner with the ball. Christian Davis will finally exit the floor, I think, for the first time this afternoon. His skin a completely different color than it was when he began the game. He is quite red. Steven Stewart checks in, 5'11 senior guard from Charleston, South Carolina. Nate Bradley will inbound to Sean Edwards momentarily.
Truett-McConnell looks like they're coming out in a zone defense here, the trapping zone, half court.
Renee Scott, catch and shoot right there just inside the three-point line. 42-40 is the Faulkner lead, 11:54 to play. The next timeout will be our under-12 media timeout. Bonilla passes across to LaTorre. He finds Stewart. Stewart working back around, defended by Renee Scott. Bonilla to Book. Book sends it out, stolen by Sean Edwards. And there's a foul call there on Calvin White. Calvin White picks up his third. That's our under-12 media timeout. Faulkner up 42-30, 11:36 to play in the game. This is the Faulkner Sports Network presentation of Faulkner Eagle Basketball.
I don't know if there's anything I like better than good barbecue. Full Moon has the best barbecue and best smoked wings in town, and those onion rings are out of this world. Go buy after the game and use your ticket for a buy one, get one free barbecue sandwich. Say hi to Chris in person at 7660 East Chase Parkway or give him a call at 334-676-5999.
Whether you're making the trip to see the Eagles play in person, coming into town to visit your favorite Faulkner student, or having the family in from out of town, Drury Inn & Suites is Faulkner's number one place to stay in Montgomery. Drury offers a full free breakfast and dinner with your stay and caters to your needs with a friendly and knowledgeable staff. They're pet friendly and offer a great Faulkner rate. They even got indoor and outdoor pool options. Call them at 334-273-1101 to book your stay today.
So Adnan Halilovic with his first career double-double, he's at 18-12 right now. That's also a career high in both categories. His previous career high rebounds, 9. His previous career high points, 17. 42-40, Faulkner leads 11:33 to play in the game. Sean Edwards across the timeline gets it to Renee Scott. Scott works around the top. Finds C.J. Jones, Adnan Halilovic, thought better of it, feeds Sean Edwards. Edwards free throw line, kicks it out to Bradley, 12 on the shot clock. There's Halilovic again, long pass to Jones, finds Edwards. He shoots it with 8 on the shot clock, and it's good. He's in double figures now as that one goes in, 44-40 with 11:05 to play.
Edwards has a knack for knocking down those desperation shots, doesn't he?
He does. The attack from Calvin White, but he is called for the walk. If we had a student section, they may chant, "You can't do that," but the students aren't back here yet. Nate Bradley inbounds it to Sean Edwards. Edwards across the timeline finds Adnan Halilovic. Adnan to Renee Scott. Renee Scott, C.J. Jones pulls the three, no good. Rebound, Christian Davis. Davis to Kyle Lambert. Bonilla with it left wing, defended by Renee Scott. He tips it alive. Sean Edwards comes up with it. Scott chases it down, draws the contact, and gets it to go. 46-40 and one opportunity coming.
Good body control there by Renee Scott. It jumped basically into the body of the defender, get the call, still had the wherewithal to get the shot up and in. And now he has the opportunity for the three-point play to extend the Faulkner lead back out to 7 with 10 and a half minutes remaining here in the second half.
Scott steps to the line. Free throw up and good. 47-40. He's got 7. Faulkner leads by 7. Christian Davis across the timeline defended by Nate Bradley. Davis hands it off to LaTorre. LaTorre gets a screen from Book, works around top of the key, passes right wing, to Antonio Bonilla. Bonilla attacks, sends it out to Christian Davis. Shot clock at 11 as he pulls a three, and it's good. And he'll have an and-one opportunity. That is a killer.
Nate Bradley there with a swipe as Davis was getting ready to pull the shot up. Gets hit with the foul.
Drains the three and goes to the line. So Davis to complete the four-point play, can't do it. Halilovic had control of the rebound when the foul was called.
Foul's going to be on number 15, that's Inaka Frankie.
So Frankie fouls Halilovic as Halilovic was grabbing the rebound. So 47-43, Faulkner with the lead. Frankie picking up his first foul of the game. Renee Scott. C.J. Jones, Sean Edwards. Edwards backs out, feeds Renee Scott. Shot clock inside of 10. Faulkner up by four, got to get this thing off. Gets it to Bradley. His pass out to Edwards, and he is fouled. And he flung it up, and it near about went in.
Don't think he's going to get the continuation.
No, but it would have been fun to watch.
Fouls on Christian Davis.
Davis picks up his second foul there. Oh, clean up the wet spot from Christian Davis hitting the deck. 9:40 to play in the game. Faulkner leads 47-43. It was Christian Davis's three moments ago that stopped a 7-0 Faulkner run. Sean Edwards to the line. He's got 10 on the afternoon.
Where he's an 85% free throw shooter, so typically good.
First one up.
And, of
no
course.
No good. The David Turner jinx strikes again. Frankie grabs the rebound and sets up the McConnell offense to Bonilla. Bonilla to Davis. Davis to Book. Book will attack left side, hands it off to Thrower. Thrower back around to Frankie. He runs through Halilovic, and an offensive foul called on Inaka Frankie. Halilovic, it doesn't show up in the stat sheet, but he's drawing a couple of those today, too.
I think that's his third one he's drawn this afternoon.
Yeah.
It's another one of the things that he's doing. Give him points, give him rebounds, give him Oscars. You know, he's getting it
that's
all.
That's right. Points, rebounds, and Academy Awards. Adnan Halilovic doing it all. 47-43 is the lead for Faulkner. Trace Hill will trigger the inbound here in just a moment. It's Bradley, Edwards, Halilovic, Hill, and Scott. You're five for the Eagles. Edwards across the timeline quickens the pace. Feeds Renee Scott, thought about the three, steps back, now finds Trace Hill. Hill to Edwards. Edwards will attack, split the defense, lose the ball, run into contact, but he didn't have the ball, and Edwards is down. Edwards is still down. And you're going to get a stoppage, finally. As Sean Edwards has not gotten up off the deck yet. Sean Edwards works his way over to the bench where Faulkner trainers will check on him. They'll get a sub in here. Got to hope that the senior point guard is okay, though. C.J. Jones checks in. So it's Bradley, Scott, Jones, Halilovic, and Hill. And Edwards is up and will be helped back to the trainer's table. He is putting weight on both feet, which is a good sign. He pinballed off of about two defenders before he hit the floor on that last attack. Tipped alive by Nate Bradley. He'll chase it down, take it all the way in, and lay it up 49-43. Nate Bradley does it himself.
Way to read the passing lane by Bradley right there. Knocked the ball forward. Easy, fast break for Bradley.
Jacob Book with the basketball. He will attack, pull it up, pull up jumper, free throw line, good. That was just nice and simple. Renee Scott across the timeline. It's still a four-point Faulkner lead. Bradley, Hill, right wing C.J. Jones. Up top, Renee Scott. Scott will curl it around and back over to C.J. Jones. 14 on the shot clock. Jones attacks all the way in. Right hand gets it to go. That was pretty.
Good strong take by Jones. Getting into the rim right there for the 2 points.
Bonilla to Thrower. Thrower to Davis. Davis attacks left side. He's picked up by Halilovic. Makes him give up the dribble. Bonilla tips it to Thrower, and Thrower drains the three. 51-48.
Good touch pass by Bonilla. Kick it back down in the corner to the open three there for Truett-McConnell.
Hill to Scott. Davis gets into the body of Scott. Christian Davis picks up his fourth foul.
Looks like they're going to leave Davis in the ball game,
yeah,
at least for now.
Make sure I've got that right. Has Davis got three or four, Carter? Davis has three. All right. Davis has three. It's Kyle Lambert with four. I read that line wrong. Renee Scott's first free throw goes. His second forthcoming. It's good. So Renee Scott's at nine. All of them, I think, here in the second half. Most of them, at least. Christian Davis, catch and shoot, three goes. Truett-McConnell won't go away. 53-51 as Christian Davis drains that. He's got 13. Hill to Bradley. Bradley over to Renee Scott. Scott, pull up three. He gets buckets. That's 12 for Renee Scott. 56-51 is the Faulkner lead. Jacob Book fakes the handoff to Thrower, loses the ball, finds Christian Davis. His three goes. He also gets buckets.
He does.
He's got 16.
Bradley went for the steal there as the ball is on the ground, got away from Davis, and that leaves Davis wide open for the three there.
Renee Scott, Adnan Halilovic. Halilovic finds a cutting C.J. Jones. He goes up with it, has it knocked away. Guess who? Halilovic feeds Bradley. The three is good. Adnan Halilovic with the assist. Nate Bradley with the three.
Two fantastic passes there from Adnan Halilovic. The first to Jones, who we wasn't able to corral it. Halilovic gets it back, gets it right out to Bradley for the wide open three.
59-54, Faulkner leads. 6:25 to go. This is the Faulkner Sports Network presentation of Faulkner Eagle Basketball.
Pizza for $5? Pizza for $5. Hot and ready pizza for $5. That's Little Caesars guarantee. Hot and ready pizza is every single day for $5. They deliver to campus right here at Faulkner University. Order one or get enough for everybody. Call 334-272-4595 or stop by their location at 5853 Atlanta Highway in Eastdale Square.
Nobody does service like Don Duncan's All-American Auto and Tire. That's not just hyperbole. With every oil change, they'll rotate your tires and vacuum out your car. That, Faulkner fans, is service. Show your Faulkner ID and get 10% off your purchase. Don Duncan's All-American Auto and Tire. Downtown Montgomery, at the corner of Bell and Vaughn, and in Millbrook.
59-54, Faulkner leads. 6:25 to play. That last exchange, Adnan Halilovic catching a blocked shot and feeding Nate Bradley in the corner, who drained the three. Truett-McConnell with the basketball. That's Kyle Lambert. He finds Jacob Book. Book back to Kyle Lambert. Lambert thrower. Thrower Davis. He's D'd up by Nate Bradley. He'll get a screen from White. Wave it off. Long pass caught by Thrower. Touch pass Kyle Lambert. He passes Jacob Book. His three won't go. C.J. Jones took the rebound out of the hands of Adnan Halilovic, but it will stay with Faulkner. And now we go to a media timeout. 5:56 to go. Still a 5-point Faulkner lead. This is the Faulkner Sports Network presentation. Faulkner Eagle basketball.
For the best in starters, salad, steaks, ribs, country dinners, and more, saddle up after the game and head on over to Texas Roadhouse, located at 7525 East Chase Parkway in Montgomery. You can even take your Faulkner game ticket and Faulkner alumnus tray, too. We'll gladly give you 10% off your bill. Call him for your catering needs at 334-396-7774 or go by and throw back a few peanuts while you wait on your meal. Texas Roadhouse, located in East Chase across from Target.
Wells Printing is so much more than just a print shop. Not only did they print up our Faulkner football game tickets, but they also carry Faulkner polos and Comfort Colors t-shirts, as well as those awesome baseball caps and stadium seats. For any and all printing and promotional item needs, call Amanda at 334-270-9481 or 334-324-0864.
.556 to go in the game. Faulkner leads 59-54 over Truett-McConnell. Inbound from Trace Hill to Renee Scott.
Truett-McConnell comes with pressure and backs off as Scott begins to bring the ball up the court.
Scott to Hill, back over to Renee Scott. He will attack and gets it to go. Another and one opportunity coming for Renee Scott as he gets the floater to go and draws the foul. He sends a little grin to the bench as he steps to the line. He's got 14.
He's really come on here in the second half, too, which has been big for this Faulkner basketball team.
Missed the free throw. Calvin White grabs it. 61-54 is the score. Faulkner leads, so Calvin White grabbed that rebound, and now all the way up is Tisby. He misses the shot. Calvin White with another rebound. And a foul call. So Calvin White gets the rebound and the putback and draws the foul. .51-56, Faulkner leads. To the line goes Calvin White. The foul call was against Nate Bradley. Tisby rebounds, and guess who? Christian Davis hits a three off the assist from Tisby. Renee Scott attacks, and he's fouled.
7-point lead has disappeared. It's back down to 2 with 5 minutes 10 seconds remaining here in the second half.
All right, reset that sequence for you. Calvin White missed the free throw. Tisby got the rebound, kicked it to Christian Davis, who drained that 3, and it's 61-59, and Christian Davis has a game-high 19 now, David. Renee Scott's free throw up and good. 62-59, Faulkner leads. Renee Scott now with 15. Second free throw, good. So Renee Scott with 16. 63-59 is the Faulkner lead. Christian Davis across the timeline. Left wing to Tisby. He attacks. C.J. Jones defends. To thrower. His three, no good. Rebound, Tisby. A lot of offensive boards going right now for Truett-McConnell. That's 3 offensive boards in the last minute. And Adnan Halilovic goes down in pain. He yelped as he went down. We'll see if Adnan's able to get up and continue, but he seems to be favoring something. 4:49 to play. 63-59 is the lead for Faulkner. And Adnan Halilovic is up. He's going to come out of the game. He's got 18 and 12, leading Faulkner in both categories. He will come off under his own power, which is good. Get a timeout from Truett-McConnell here. We'll take it with him. This is the Faulkner Sports Network presentation of Faulkner Eagle Basketball.
Okay, so it's a given that they've got the catchiest jingle of all time. But Cook's has used reliable, affordable, expert service to become number one in the pest control business. Nobody wants the uninvited guests at their game day parties. Call Cook's Pest Control to handle the problem outside before it moves its way inside. Call Mike at 334-273-8873 and get a free quote today. Maybe you need a loan to help you slide behind the wheel of that new ride. Perhaps it's a home loan or a HELOC you're seeking. Guardian Credit Union can help. With competitive interest rates on every loan product, Guardian is here to serve you with an unparalleled level of customer service, state-of-the-art online banking, and locations all over Montgomery.
4:49 to go in the game. Faulkner leads Truett-McConnell 63-59. The five on the floor for the Eagles, Jacob Spence, Trace Hill, C.J. Jones, Nate Bradley, Renee Scott. Kyle Lambert will inbound it for Truett-McConnell. Gets it into Christian Davis. He leads all scorers with 19. Davis to Lambert. Lambert to Thrower. Thrower back up top to Tisby, who resets it to Davis. Shot clock at 9 when he shoots that long three from NBA range and drains it. He's got 22, and he's keeping Truett in it. And you're going to get a Faulkner timeout here from Coach Garrett Sanderson. We'll take it with him. This is the Faulkner Sports Network presentation of Faulkner Eagle Basketball.
From hand-breaded chicken fingers and fried chicken to delicious sides and scratch-made biscuits, Jack's has all the ingredients to make your next tailgate legendary. Football is just better with Jack's. So order ahead at eatatjacks.com and score big this season.
Maybe you need to update your life insurance coverage. Perhaps you're thinking about retirement. It could be an accident or a cancer policy that you're seeking. Whatever your insurance needs, make sure that you're covered at a rate that makes sense for you and your family. That's where Ronnie Polk and Benefit Planners can help. Call Ronnie or Brian at 334-495-7476. Call Benefit Planners and make sure that your family is covered. Odds are you've never seen service like what you'll see when you go into Don Duncan's All-American Auto and Tire. They rotate your tires and vacuum out your vehicle just because you came in for an oil change. And if you call Nathan at the downtown Montgomery location at 334-263-3872, he'll pick up your car and bring it back to you when the job is done. They've got three locations to serve you, and they'll give you 10% off with your Faulkner ID. Don Duncan's All-American Auto and Tire, downtown Montgomery, the corner of Bell and Vaughn and Millbrook.
Faulkner leading by one, 4:11 to go. C.J. Jones to Sean Edwards. Shot clock at 8. Edwards-Jones, long three. Good! C.J. Jones now with double figures. That's four Eagles in double digits. Christian Davis has done yeoman's work for the Bears. He's got 22 and he's got the basketball. Goes to Tisby, right wing Bonilla. Bonilla D'd up by the much longer Jones. Gets it to Thrower. 14 on the shot clock. Thrower finds White. Spin move, goes around and gets it to go with the right hand. The lead is 2 for Faulkner. Good to see Adnan Hulilovic and Sean Edwards both back in. So Faulkner nearly with all of its starting lineup in there. There's Renee Scott with the basketball as he backs off with 13 on the shot clock. He'll work around, now passes it to Hulilovic. His three rims out. Boy, I think the place would have come unglued with that one. Thrower, head fake, brings it around, finds White, pull up just inside the three-point line, won't go. Tisby with the rebound and a foul call. That's on C.J. Jones. That's his second. Makai Lambert will check in. Bonilla will check out. 3:02 to play in the game. Eagles lead by two.
Faulkner struggling here to control the defensive rebounds. Allowed several offensive rebounds for this Truett-McConnell team here in the last several possessions.
Dumps it down low to Kai Lambert. Feeds White. He attacks, won't go. Halilovic, strong rebound and a jump ball. So Halilovic gets the rebound, gets it tied up.
Got a foul.
Oh, it's a foul. That's on Kai Lambert, and that's his fifth. So Halilovic gets the rebound. Kai Lambert fouls him, and Lambert is out.
And Halilovic gets two shots at the free throw lines. I believe they're in the double bonus at this point.
Absolutely. So Kai Lambert out of the game. Bonilla will check back in. Lambert's afternoon done. He finishes 4 points, three rebounds, two assists, five fouls. Garrett Sanderson will check in momentarily. Adnan Halilovic to the free throw line. First one up and no good. C.J. Jones comes out. Edwards, Scott, Bradley, Sanderson, and Halilovic. Halilovic's second free throw, no good. Rebound tipped alive. And a foul call against Faulkner. That'll be on Adnan. It's two on Adnan Halilovic. So Sanderson will check right back out. They're going a little offense for defense here. C.J. Jones comes back in. Bonilla will shoot two free throws with his team down two and 2:53 to play in the game. First free throw up, no good. He'll shoot one and one, correction. Jones got the rebound, fed Sean Edwards. Edwards will come across the timeline. Works around to the right, hands it off to Nate Bradley. Davis gambled and lost on that one. Long three from the corner, no good. Rebound controlled by number 10, Calvin White. Davis will quicken the pace across the timeline. He curls it back around, finds White. White gives it off to Tisby. Tisby finds Davis, defended tightly by Bradley. And he will be fouled by C.J. Jones as he tries to turn the corner. C.J. Jones with his third foul. That'll put Davis at the line with a chance to tie it. Milan Skundrich comes back in for the first time in a long time.
Davis, the 65% free throw shooter on the season.
Davis steps to the line. First shot up and good. He's got 23 on the afternoon. One-point game, 2:15 to play. Second free throw, no good. Rebound, Milan Skundrich. Skundrich gives it to Sean Edwards. Edwards across the timeline. Gets it to Skundrich. He attacks, goes all the way in, gets the right-hand layup to go. Milan Skundrich, instant impact. Faulkner leads by three.
Strong take there by Skundrich to get his way into the basket, keep the defender on his hip for the layup there to extend the lead back up to three for the Eagles.
Truett-McConnell will take the timeout, 68-65. Faulkner leads 1:53 to go. This is a Faulkner Sports Network presentation of Faulkner Eagle basketball.
For the best in starters, salad, steaks, ribs, country dinners, and more, saddle up after the game and head on over to Texas Roadhouse, located at 7525 East Chase Parkway in Montgomery. You can even take your Faulkner game ticket and Faulkner alumnus tray, too. We'll gladly give you 10% off your bill. Call him for your catering needs at 334-396-7774 or go by and throw back a few peanuts while you wait on your meal. Texas Roadhouse, located in East Chase across from Target.
Wells Printing is so much more than just a print shop. Not only did they print up our Faulkner football game tickets, but they also carry Faulkner polos and Comfort Colors t-shirts, as well as those awesome baseball caps and stadium seats. For any and all printing and promotional item needs, call Amanda at 334-270-9481 or 334-324-0864.
.153 to play. Faulkner leads Truett-McConnell 68-65. Darius Tisby, freshman from Nashville, Georgia, will throw the ball in. Throws it into the backcourt where Jacob Book will corral it. Book, or Davis rather, feeds it back to Tisby. We got a scrum on the floor, a fight for the ball. Adnan Halilovic was in the middle of it. Buck 43 to play.
It's a great play there by Renee Scott. Knocked the ball away from the offensive player. Then we see again the hustle from Adnan Halilovic diving on the loose ball, forcing the jump ball situation, which possession stays with Truett-McConnell, but it gives Faulkner the next possession in one of those situations, which with a minute 43 left could be pivotal.
Absolutely. Doesn't count for anything in the stats, but it certainly matters to his team. 15 seconds left on the shot clock.
Wiping up the water on the floor from the scrum for the ball.
Christian Davis will inbound the ball. Gets it into Tisby. And an easy layup for Tisby cuts it to one. 68-67 with a buck 35 to go in the game. Sean Edwards across the timeline with the basketball. We'll work toward his bench and call timeout. We'll take it with him. Faulkner up one. This is the Faulkner Sports Network presentation of Faulkner Eagle Basketball.
From hand-breaded chicken fingers and fried chicken to delicious sides and scratch-made biscuits, Jack's has all the ingredients to make your next tailgate legendary. Football is just better with Jack's. So order ahead at eatatjacks.com and score big this season.
Okay, so it's a given that they've got the catchiest jingle of all time. But Cooks has used reliable, affordable, expert service to become number one in the pest control business. Nobody wants the uninvited guests at their game day parties. Call Cooks Pest Control to handle the problem outside before it moves its way inside. Call Mike at 334-273-8873 and get a free quote today.
Minute 29 to play in the game. Faulkner leads 68-67, and they have the basketball. Renee Scott will trigger the inbound right in front of our broadcast position. Skundrich, Halilovic, Edwards, and Jones round out the five on the floor for Faulkner. Tisby, Thrower, White, Book, and Davis are the five for Truett-McConnell. Scott feeds Jones, down low to Halilovic, back up top to Scott, left wing Edwards. He will pull it up just inside the three-point line and miss it, rebound by Book. So Truett-McConnell coming the other way, down one with a minute six to play. Davis, left wing thrower, his three, good. Faulkner trails by two with 58 seconds to go in the game. Sean Edwards across the timeline. Passes it around to Skundrich. Out to Edwards. Pull up mid-range. No. Rebound. And we got a whistle on the floor. Jump ball is the signal here. Tisby's having to be pulled away. That's huge for Faulkner because of what you pointed out earlier, David.
Double foul, double foul.
Double foul. It's on Tisby for Truett-McConnell. It's on C.J. Jones for Faulkner. And because of the possession arrow that Adnan Halilovic stole about a minute ago, Faulkner's going to keep the basketball. And another timeout by Faulkner as they trail by two with 39.4 to play. Scott Sanderson wants to draw it up. This is the Faulkner Sports Network presentation of Faulkner Eagle Basketball.
Maybe you need a loan to help you slide behind the wheel of that new ride. Perhaps it's a home loan or a HELOC you're seeking. Guardian Credit Union can help. With competitive interest rates on every loan product, Guardian is here to serve you with an unparalleled level of customer service, state-of-the-art online banking, and locations all over Montgomery.
From hand-breaded chicken fingers and fried chicken to delicious sides and scratch-made biscuits, Jack's has all the ingredients to make your next tailgate legendary. Football is just better with Jack's, so order ahead at eatatjacks.com and score big this season.
Long inbound comes to C.J. Jones. 9-second differential between shot and game. Jones to Skundrich, and he gets it to go, and the game is tied. 31 seconds to play. They're going to reset the clock. They want 32.4 on the game clock. 30 seconds on the shot clock. 2.4 second differential between shot and game. Book will inbound the ball to Davis. Skundrich, Scott, Jones, Halilovic, Edwards, the five for Faulkner. Davis, Book, White, Tisby, and it looks like Latore, the five for Truett-McConnell. Truett content to run shot clock, much like what we saw at the end of the first half, and Davis will call timeout. Truett-McConnell takes the timeout. 70-all, 16.2 to play in regulation. This is the Faulkner Sports Network presentation of Faulkner Eagle Basketball.
Maybe you need to update your life insurance coverage. Perhaps you're thinking about retirement. It could be an accident or a cancer policy that you're seeking. Whatever your insurance needs, make sure that you're covered at a rate that makes sense for you and your family. That's where Ronnie Polk and Benefit Planners can help. Call Ronnie or Brian at 334-495-7476. Call Benefit Planners and make sure that your family is covered. Odds are you've never seen service like what you'll see when you go into Don Duncan's All-American Auto and Tire. They rotate your tires and vacuum out your vehicle just because you came in for an oil change. And if you call Nathan at the downtown Montgomery location at 334-263-3872, he'll pick up your car and bring it back to you when the job is done. They've got three locations to serve you, and they'll give you 10% off with your Faulkner ID. Don Duncan's All-American Auto and Tire, downtown Montgomery, the corner of Bell and Vaughn and Millbrook.
70-all is your score, 16.2 to play. Truett-McConnell with the basketball, 14 seconds on the shot clock. They get it in backcourt to Christian Davis. He'll take his time coming across the timeline. Shot clock at 7. He attacks right side. He's going to go all the way in. Gets it to White. Sanderson wanted a walk. He's not going to get it. The shot goes. And a timeout by Faulkner with 4.6 to play. Sanderson wanted a walk as Davis took about 3 steps there. But not going to get it. 72-70, Faulkner trails with 4.6 to play.
No situations. You can't wait for the referee to bail you out with the travel call. You just got to play defense and do what you've got to do. Davis smartly, he did travel, but he made the right play. Gets the ball there right in front of the rim, and it goes for the easy layup for Truett-McConnell. Coach Scott Sanderson has to try to draw up a play here to get an easy look for Faulkner, either tie this game or win it here for the Eagles.
Yeah.
And here we go. 4.6 to play. Faulkner down two. Edwards, Skundrich, Halilovic, Jones, and Scott are your five for Faulkner.
The bad thing is you've got to go the length of the floor here for Faulkner, which adds to the difficulty of the task at hand.
Sean Edwards throws it into Renee Scott. Gets a screen, now passes off to Edwards. He has to throw it on three-quarter court, and he can't replicate it. Back iron, no good. He did it in the first half, couldn't do it in the second, and Faulkner falls here, losing its third straight. 72-70, Truett-McConnell prevails over the Eagles in Tyne Davis. We wrap it up after this. This is the Faulkner Sports Network presentation of Faulkner Eagle Basketball.
Located on Boyd Cooper Parkway in East Chase, Candlewood Suites is one of the premier lodging destinations in Montgomery. All rooms are big enough for the whole family, and they offer a super rate for Faulkner folks. Next time you're in town to see the Eagles play in person, book your stay at Candlewood Suites of East Chase Park. Call 334-277-0677 and have a super night's sleep.
Wherever you are in your financial needs, Guardian Credit Union can probably help. From auto to home to signature loans, Guardian has the best rates you'll find anywhere. They even do credit cards with no annual fees. Join today and get your Eagle credit or debit card. With locations all over Montgomery, Guardian Credit Union is here to serve.
Bring in Coach Scott Sanderson now to wrap it up. A 72-70 loss to Truett-McConnell. Coach, we talked about it coming out of the road trip. Again today, 17 turnovers, that number a little higher than you'd like it to be. It did get better, it seemed, in the second half, but left yourself in a little bit of a hole in terms of the possessions you lost in the first half.
Yeah, in the first half we lost 18 possessions. We turned the ball over 12 times, which was multiple ones were unforced. We gave up six offensive rebounds, so that's 18 possessions that they got. We didn't shoot the ball particularly well, but the reason we were winning was because of our defense. And in the second half, you know, they shoot 65% from the floor, and you don't beat anybody doing that. And you have to give those guys credit. They played well. The right guys shot the ball for them, and they deserve to win today.
It's one of those obviously not the result, but Adnan Halilovic was great for you for most of this one, a career high for him in both points and rebounds. How much of a difference did he make for you down there?
Well, he was good. You know, he probably played too many minutes. He hadn't played that many minutes this year for us, and that's just from a lack of other guys not playing. And we've had, you know, the last three or four games, even the games we won prior to us getting beat, we have not played particularly well. We just hadn't played very good. And sometimes that can snowball on you, and today we just weren't very good on either end of the floor, and you get beat.
Not a lot of time to turn around and get ready to go back into conference play January the 3rd. What do you see coming up in this trip with Dalton and Martin?
Well, that's a huge trip because, I mean, you can get away from us. We're 2-2 in the league. We dropped a couple of games on the road, 2 weeks ago. So it's a huge trip for us. Dalton's a good team. They've been a little inconsistent so far this year, but the last four or five games, we haven't been very consistent either. So I'm more at this point, you know, after the way we play today, I'm more concerned about us more so than I am who we're playing.
What's the practice schedule look like for you over the next week as you get ready for that one?
We'll practice at least three of the 4 days. At least three of the 4 days. You know, we're not in school, and we might go a couple times, you know, some of the days. But we just, you know, again, we're in a little bit of funk. We didn't shoot the ball. In the first half, we're up three, and the only reason we're up three because we guarded pretty good. We didn't shoot the ball very well at all. And, you know, like I said, I told him at halftime, we keep playing the way we're going to play, you're going to let a last-second shot beat you or potentially beat you. You don't want to put yourself in that situation, and that's exactly what we did.
Coach, we wish we had better results today. We look forward to being back with you here on January the 10th, and roll tide, buddy.
All right, thank you.
Coach Scott Sanderson from the Faulkner Eagle basketball team. As he said, David, I think he put the nail on the head. You play the way they did. You leave yourself open to being beat by a last-second shot, and that's exactly what happened to him today.
Absolutely, and the turnovers are one thing, but then in the second half, the inability of Faulkner to get the defensive rebound, there were several possessions in a row where where Truett-McConnell gets the offensive rebound and they're able to run another possession, run more time, and that's a lot of times that's where you get an easy look is right off an easy rebound or an offensive rebound, and that happened several times in the second half late in the game for them, and to allow them to stay in the game and shrink the lead from Faulkner and then eventually take it here late in the game.
Your final box, four players in double figures for Faulkner, 18 points, 12 rebounds for Adnan Halilovic, 16 points for Renee Scott. Actually, this is, I'm looking one box too early, 18 points, 13 rebounds, I think, is your final for Adnan Halilovic.
That's not a foul.
There we go. Carter now passing it to us. 18 points, 13 rebounds for Adnan Halilovic, 16 points Renee Scott, 10 each for Sean Edwards and C.J. Jones. Christian Davis is the leader for Truett-McConnell, 23 points. Darius Thrower with 15. Faulkner out-rebounded 33-32 in the game. Truett-McConnell shoots 49.1% from the floor. Really hard to beat a team that's shooting that well.
It is, and story of the game, especially the second half for Truett-McConnell, was Christian Davis, 6 of 9 from the three-point line here in the game in 36 minutes played, so just an all-around really good game for him. He led this team down the stretch, and he squeezed out the win for this Truett-McConnell team here this afternoon over Faulkner Eagles, and that's all there is to it.
We are back here on Monday for Faulkner women's basketball when they will host Campbellsville at noon. On Tuesday, we will host Thomas at 2 p.m. Again, Faulkner women's basketball. The men are back home on January the 10th in league play against Stillman. We'll be here for that one as well. For Christopher Nam and Jacob Hartsfield, for Carter Moles and David Turner, I am Jeremy Smith. This has been the Faulkner Sports Network presentation of Faulkner Eagle Basketball. Good night. God bless you.